Good morning, Eagle Nation. It is Monday, the 10th of January. It is the 91st day of school. We are now past the midway point and headed into the second half of the year. Wherever you may be, please stop and stand. Let's rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Before you are seated, if you'd like to join me in 10 for the day, let's knock them out. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I started the day off with 50, so we're up to 60. I could use your help getting to 100 if you got time today. Let's do it. I think we're up to day 37 of 100 push-ups. That's like 3,700 push-ups. In any case, announcement for the day. It's a new day and a new week. The song that you just heard was the Batman theme song. And I wanted to share this with you. I finally went through. There have been 77 responses that have come in from mostly 7th and 8th graders, but students in about 5 grades total. It's not too late if you haven't. Please click the link below this video and you can still share with us who would win in a face-off between Batman versus Spider-Man. But today, I thought I would share with you the theme song from Batman, and I put on note cards all of the things that you guys had to say. So today, we're just going to look at Batman, and instead of reading them out loud to you, I'm gonna share these with you while the Batman theme song plays in the background, and you can read them on the screen. So teachers, you can read them out loud to your class, or if there's a classmate who would like to be identified to read them out loud to the class, that would be acceptable too. But here they are. This is why Batman would defeat Spider-Man, according to the Batman lovers out there. He has prep time. And that's it for today. Those are all the reasons why Batman would allegedly defeat Spider-Man. Now, tomorrow I'll share with you all of the reasons that Spider-Man would allegedly defeat Batman. And then we'll start to actually take these. This is actually a really effective technique for organizing your writing, is to just start out by putting down all the words on index cards, just like this. And then after we've heard Spider-Man's ideas, we can actually start to organize these into groups or categories. And then we can see which are the most compelling arguments or reasons, and then we can follow with the process, the writing process, to set up either our sentence, our paragraph, our 3-paragraph essay, or our 5-paragraph essay, and I'll have more details for you to come. So right now, we're still getting all the thoughts out on the page. That's it for that for today. Teachers, just as a reminder, this week, some things coming up in the week at a glance. It is cycle 5 for grades 1 through 3. Continue to study hard, work hard. We're gonna be passing out hard color copies of the results from Abe's Web Plus. I'm asking teachers to post those outside your school door just for everybody to see, students to see, and for you as a teacher to see, to remind you that that didn't happen by chance. It didn't happen by accident. It happened by a whole lot of people in this school, staff, classified, certified, and students working together for 3 years now to make the kind of change that is happening and really manifesting itself at the second and third grade levels. But that's important because those same readers become fourth graders and fifth graders and so on all the way to eighth grade. And our job is to get them ready for high school. So it was a collective effort. It is a collective effort. And I want us to be reminded of that for the remainder of the month of January. So when you get your hard copies, please put them outside in whatever arrangement you please, but put them outside on your door. So students, you see those every day. Your growth and learning matters to all of us here at Emerson. Vocabulary Surge Week 8 starts this week. CTMs will be held this week. There are three today and two on Wednesday. The iReady Winter Diagnostic also begins today. So this is an assessment that you guys will take, students, so you can see how much have you grown since August. We did it in August. We're taking it again here in January, and you'll take it one more time at the end of the school year to see those 3 points in time. How have you grown in two subjects, specifically reading and math? So do your best on the test and be excited about the growth that you'll see when we give the results back to you. Parent-teacher conferences are coming up here at the end of this month. COVID pool test day 13 will be tomorrow. Also tomorrow afternoon, if you're on the PBIS committee, you have a meeting tomorrow after school with Ms. Burris in her classroom. The 100th anniversary committee will also meet this week on Thursday. We're now about 6 weeks out from our celebration day of February 27th. So we hope to see all of you there then. We need your help to get this sucker to launch. And teachers, your MTSS teacher feedback form is due. The deadline is Friday of this week. Those are all the biggest highlights, I believe. Student council should be meeting this week. Basketball will be starting soon. They have a coaches meeting, I believe, tonight. Ms. Robbins has posted many things for us as a staff and teachers. If you have time for a quick read or you need a resource for Learning for Justice, Ms. Robbins has posted those in the WAG. Your Wednesday PD will be your DCTM, so be on the lookout for email from your facilitator for what to expect, where to be, and what to bring. With that, let's get some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning, students. Today is on the topic of kindness. If you didn't read the article about the last surviving World War II veteran who passed away on Wednesday of last week, he was 112 years old, and his parting words were, "Be kind." But here's some more words of wisdom to add to those. Most of us want to be liked and appreciated by others. We want to have friends who love and respect us. We want our parents and teachers and coaches to like us too. It feels good to be well-liked, don't you think? Listen to what Dr. Norman Vincent Peale, the great American author and speaker, has to say about being liked. Getting people to like you is only the other side of liking them. In other words, when we try to be kind and show others what we like about them, they will, usually, like us in return. Sounds like the golden rule again, doesn't it? We could say, like others as you would have them like you. Today, look for the good in yourself and in others. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Mask up, keep your distance, and then add 6 inches to a foot more. Stay in your zones or your cohorts. And if you have a cell phone, be sure that it's put away all day, every day, unless your teacher explicitly says it's okay to use it for an explicit activity that he or she supervises. And then, make it a great day, or not, Batman and Spider-Man lovers alike, the choice is yours.